Many times, brethren call other brethren. And in most cases, they call the pastors. And they say, Pastor, stand with me. Stand with me because of this. Stand with me because of that. And when they sit down, they don't tell you they have sat down. The next time you hear, they want you to stand again with them. You know, sitting down is a comfortable position. When you stand, it is battle. So when there's battle, stand with me, stand with me. And when battle is over, they are going to sit to celebrate. You don't tell the one who was standing, you leave him standing and you are already seated. So, why does that happen? It is because many times we are looking at what can I get? Or what, or how do I benefit? Amen. How do I benefit from the cross? How do I benefit from the shedding of the precious blood of Jesus Christ? How do I benefit from the stripes he received? How do I benefit from the shame he forbore? Amen. We just look at what has been paid for so that I can take it. But zeal will ask the question differently. How do I respond to him sacrificing himself for me? How do I respond to his suffering? I know it is so much, we cannot actually respond or reciprocate in a form that equates to what he did. But that he provided for our salvation and never took us home is because there is something he expects of us. Amen. There is still as long as you are still breathing, there is something expected of you. Amen.
Amen.
And the zeal will drive you to seek for that thing. Amen.
Amen.
Zeal will drive you to seek for that thing. What do I do for him who died for me? Because the Bible says clearly, Paul says it, that he died for us, that we who now live should not live for ourselves, but should live for him who died for us. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. That's why he says that it's no longer I that lives. Because for him, he knew that secret. Now, in Psalms 69. Psalms 69,
Zaburi ya 69,
verse 9.
Tisa.
For the zeal of thine house has eaten me up.
Maana wivu wa nyumba yako umenila.
I want you to see that.
Nataka uone hayo.
For the zeal of thine house has eaten me up.
Maana wivu wa nyumba yako umenila.
It has consumed me.
Imenila.
It is biting me.
Inaniuma.
It's not giving me rest. Doesn't allow me to stay in comfort zone.
Iniruhusu nisalie katika hali ya starehe.
Amen.
Amina.
The zeal of thine house doesn't allow me to stay in comfort zone.
Wivu wa nyumba yako iniruhusu niendelee kukaa katika hali ya starehe.
The zeal of thine house has consumed me.
Wivu wa nyumba yako
or is consuming me.
Ama inaendelea kunila.
Amen.
Amina.
And the reproach of them that reproach thee are fallen upon me. Amen.
Amina.
And the reproach of them that reproach thee are fallen upon me.
Na laumu zao wanao kulaumu zimenipata.
The reproach of thine house.
Inelaumu.
Has eaten me. The reproach of thine house.
Laumu.
I mean the zeal of thine house.
Wivu wa nyumba
yako. Has eaten me.
Umenila.
And the reproach of them that reproach you.
Na laumu zao wanao kulaumu.
The reproach of them that reproached you.
Laumu zao wanao kulaumu.
Them that talk bad of what you do.
Wao ambao wanaongea vibaya kuhusu ambacho unakitenda.
Them that have mocked your work.
Wale ambao umedhihaki kazi yako.
Them that blame you for anything.
Wao wanaokulaumu kwa kila kitu.
That blame falls on me.
Hiyo laumu imeni.
That mockery falls on me.
Ile dhihaka imeni.
That reproach falls on me.
Ile laumu imeni.
It gives me as much pain as though I'm the one they're addressing.
Inanipatia uchungu kiasi kwamba ni kama mimi ndiye wanayelenga.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. I don't know how you feel.
Sijui vile unahisi.
When you hear Christianity ill spoken of.
Wakati unasikia uokovu ama Ukristo ukiongelewa kinyume.
Or the name of Jesus being ill spoken of.
Ama jina la Yesu likiongelewa vibaya.
I don't know how you feel.
Sijui vile wewe uhisi.
When the church is ill spoken of.
Wakati kanisa linaongelewa vibaya.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Jina Bwana tukuzwe.
But if you have a zeal.
Lakini ikiwa wewe una shauku.
For the work of God.
Sababu ya kazi ya Mungu.
You have a zeal.
Una shauku.
For God.
Kwa Mungu.
You have a zeal.
Una shauku.
To live for him.
Kumuishia.
Any reproach.
Kila lawama.
Will not be towards God but towards, you will take it as yourself, as on your own self.
Utachukua hiyo laumu juu yako mwenyewe.
Amen.
Amen.
When you hear anybody say that the work of the Lord Jesus Christ is nothing.
Wakati unamsikia yeyote akisema kazi ya Kristo Yesu si kitu.
You will feel so much pain.
Utahisi uchungu mwingi.
Bless you be the name of the Lord.
Jina Bwana tukuzwe.
You will feel pain.
Utahisi uchungu.
When you hear that his stripes are in vain.
Wakati unasikia kwamba ile mijeledi yake ni bure.
Mapigo yake.
Mapigo yake.
If you hear that his stripes were in vain.
Kisikia kwamba mapigo yake si kitu.
You will feel hurt inside.
Utasikia umeumia kwa ndani.
If you don't feel such.
Ikiwa hauhisi hivyo.
Then I put it to you.
Basi nakwambia.
That you have not understood.
Haujaelewa.
The zeal.
Ile shauku.
You have not understood.
Haujaelewa.
Him who died for you.
Yeye aliyekufilia.
You have not understood.
Haujaelewa.
The meaning of that death.
Maana ya kile kifo.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Jina Bwana tukuzwe.
Your own biological parent.
Wazazi wako waliokuzaa.
The mother or your father.
Baba yako mama yako.
It doesn't matter what their state is.
Haijalishi hali yao ni ipi.
But if you hear them ill spoken of.
Lakini ukisikia wanaongelewa vibaya.
If you hear any blame apportioned to them for any reason.
Ukisikia lawama yote imeelekezwa kwa sababu yote ile.
Inside you there will be that urge to oppose or to resist.
Ndani mwako utakuwa na ule msukumo wa kupinga.
And if that is not there.
Na ikiwa hiyo haipo.
You don't have the honor of a parent in you.
Wewe hauna ile heshima ya baba na wazazi ndani mwako.
Amen.
Amina.
You don't have it in you.
Hauna ile.
Because if you have it.
Maana ukiwa nayo.
It will drive you.
Itakuelekeza.
To want to resist.
Kutaka kupinga.
It can drive you.
Inaweza kuelekeza.
To want to do anything.
Kutaka kufanya chochote kile.
To preserve that name.
Kuhifadhi lile jina.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. You want to do anything.
Kutaka kufanya chochote.
To preserve that name.
Kuhifadhi hilo jina.
Some can even die.
Wengine hata wanaweza kufa.
In defense of that name.
Katika kutetea lile jina.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Jina Bwana tukuzwe.
But that is a physical father.
Lakini huyo ni baba wa kiasilia.
Whose duty?
Ambaye kazi yake majukumu.
Was to bring you up.
Nilikuwa kukulea.
Amen.
Amina.
Physical parents.
Baba zako.
Whose duties were to bring you forth.
Jukumu lao lilikuwa la kuwaza.
And to bring you up.
Na kukulea.
And to prepare you for life.
Na kukuandaa kwa ajili ya
maisha. And let you continue with life.
Na kukuacha uendelee na maisha.
And can do nothing more than that.
Na hawezi fanya zaidi ya hayo.
What about him?
Inakuwaje kumhusu yeye?
Who has your eternity?
Ambaye ana umilele wako.
In his hand.
Katika mikono yake.
What about him?
Wewe inakuwaje kumhusu yeye?
Who determines? Okay, he determined your beginning.
Ambaye aliamua mwanzo wako.
and determines your current being and determines your future being to eternity. How about him? Your parents were surprised when you were born. They looked at you and they were excited. The old days, those days when we were born, they did not know whether they are going to have a boy or a girl. Thank God for you who are born in these later days. In these later days. You even go shopping, you know this one is a girl, you prepare everything for a girl. Those days when you were born, they were excited. In fact, when they are told they have got a child, they will ask, is it a boy, is it a girl? These days, I understand, they start showering them when they are still inside. Understand, they do baby shower when you are still inside. Because they even know the type of child. But those days, men, the parents were getting surprised, or they were getting news. Getting news. Even the Bible, it says that the woman, when she's in labor, she's in pain, she's weeping in pain. But when she has given birth, she is told, be of good cheer because she has given birth to a baby boy. Amen. It is at that point that they know what it is. What about God, who knew that it was a boy before you conceived? How much more should we have zeal for him? If we can have zeal for our parents, zeal for the brethren, or your brother, your physical brother. When I was in standard 3, and my brother was in standard 4, I remember one evening, he was much bigger than me. He was 6 years older than me. So it means that his age mates were 6 years and above older than me. But one evening, when school was just over, and we were walking home, and then at a certain point, there are some two boys fighting. They were big. But I discovered that it was a boy on top of my brother. Despite the fact that I was small, I dived on that person like a tornado. He did not know what hit him because I put the whole of my weight on him. I did not even think, what if he comes out and starts beating me instead of my brother? Because he also got surprised, he could not even fight anymore. Amen. Zeal for a brother. I know you could also do the same for your brother or your sister. Amen. But what about God? And what about his body, the brethren? What about his house? Blessed be the name of the Lord. Have you ever, okay, those of you who have parents at home, have you ever gone home and looked at your parents' house and then you say, I think I should do something about this roof. This roof is bringing shame to this home. Or I will pull down this one and put up another one. Do I have anybody who has ever thought like that about his parents or about home? Can I see your hand? If you are not there, then this, okay, there are so many. If you were not there, then this place would be a false place. If you would not be here, then this place would be a false place. A place where, which doesn't teach you how to respect your and honor your parents would not be a good place for you. But I've seen a number of you. Amen. I've seen a number of you. And you are saying, yes, I've sometimes looked at the things and I've said, these things are not pleasant, I will change the status of
them.
I don't like the way my mother or my father is staying, I'll change this house. I don't have the ability to bring it down, but I'll change the roof. Or even if it is a grass patch one, you say, because it is leaking, I'll get somebody cut grass and repatch it all over.
Hata kama ni nyasi lakini inavuja maji basi nitatafuta mtu akate nyasi nyingine arejeshe ili kwamba iache kuvuja.
You have a zeal.
Una shauku.
Blessed be the name of God. And it causes you to go a step.
Kuchukua hatua.
Amen. It causes you to do something.
Inakusababisha kutenda kitu.
The other day somebody told me somewhere that I don't like how my mother is staying. I'm going to get her a place and I'm going to build for her a house. And she got a place and built the mother a house. Blessed be the name of the Lord. That's how we do in the physical. Amen. That's how we do in the physical. I don't know whether we do it because these are people we see. And the Lord we have is a Lord we assume. You know, we just assume his existence. Like when he says, I am with you always.
Niko nanyi siku zote.
We can even ask him, where are you? Where are you, Lord?
Uko wapi Bwana?
He says, I'm with you always.
Anawambia, anasema, niko nanyi
siku zote. Where are you when I was passing through this?
Unaweza mwambia, ulikuwa wapi wakati nilikuwa nikipitia haya?
Because we don't take his presence with us seriously.
Maana hatumaanishi ule uwepo wake pamoja
nasi. That's why we don't have the zeal for his house.
Ndio maana hatuna ile shauku kwa ajili ya nyumba yake.
And I'm sorry to say,
Nasikitika kusema haya.
I am sorry to say,
nasikitika kusema,
that it is manifesting more and more even in this place.
Kwamba inajidhihirisha sana na sana hata mahali hapa.
It touches my heart when I see lateness that takes place in the house of God.
Inagusa moyo wangu sana wakati naona kule kuchelewa ambao kunafanyika katika nyumba ya Mungu.
The same people who can very faithfully report to work Monday to Saturday 5 minutes or 15 minutes before the reporting time.
Watu wale wale ambao kwa uaminifu wanafika mahali pao pa kazi dakika 5 kabla ama dakika 10 kuanzia Jumatatu hadi Jumamosi.
On a Sunday,
siku ya Jumapili.
A 9 o'clock service, they report at 10.
Ibada inaanza saa 3 wanafika saa 4.
The same people can wake up in the morning.
Watu wale wale ambao wanaweza amka mapema asubuhi.
So that they can board a 6 o'clock transport to marketplace.
Ili kwamba wapande gari la kuelekeza mahali pa biashara, masokoni. Saa 12 asubuhi.
9 o'clock service, they come at 10.
Ibada ya saa 3 wanakuja saa 4.
They don't have the zeal.
Hawana shauku.
They don't have the commitment.
Hawana kujitolea.
They are not concerned about it.
Hawasumbuki kuihusu.
They can't fight for it.
Hawezi ipigania.
They can't sacrifice their sleep for it.
Hawezi toa dhabihu.
They can't sacrifice their time for it.
Hawezi tenga muda wao kwa ajili yake.
Amen.
Amina.
The same people.
Watu wale wale.
Who can sit in a family gathering?
Ambao wanaweza keti katika mkutano wa jamii ya
mafamilia. Discussing family matters.
Wakijadiliana mambo yanayohusiana na familia.
Until early hours of the morning.
Hadi masaa ya mapema ya asubuhi.
Throughout the whole night.
Usiku wote.
You tell them.
Unawaambia.
Let us pray for 1 hour on a Monday.
Tuombe kwa lisali moja siku ya
Jumatatu. You never see them.
Hautawaiona.
Let us pray one day in a week on a Friday overnight.
Wacha tuombe siku moja kwa juma usiku wa Ijumaa.
You never see them.
Hautawaiona. Kwa nini?
They love the sleep.
Wanapenda usingizi.
And therefore they don't have the zeal.
Hivyo basi hawana shauku.
When they have this, if they had the zeal,
ikiwa wangekuwa na shauku,
the sleep would not be an issue.
Ule usingizi haungekuwa
kitu. The zeal would drive them to do that which they are to do for him who died for them.
Ile shauku ingewaelekeza kutenda kile ambacho inafaa wafanye kwake yeye aliyewafilia.
We're just having a few days and the year will be over.
Tuna siku chache tu na mwaka utakuwa umemalizika.
And you can't remember when you last fasted.
Na uwezi kumbuka mara ya mwisho kufunga ni lini.
Even partial fasting, missing lunch and breakfast.
Hata tu kukosa kiamsha kinywa ama chamcha.
Because you wanted to serve your body.
Sababu ulitaka kutumikia mwili wako.
And because there's no zeal.
Na sababu hauna shauku.
Amen.
Amina.
You don't care what happens in the kingdom.
Haujali nini kinafanyika katika ufalme.
That's why today.
Ndio maana leo.
I'm talking about zeal.
Ninaongea kuhusu shauku.
That somebody's zeal may be stepped up.
Kwamba shauku la mtu likatiwe nguvu.
Because when that zeal is up, your commitment to the house of the Lord shall also be up.
Maana ile shauku likiongezeka basi kujitolea kwa ajili ya nyumba ya Mungu kutakuwa kwa hali ya juu.
And anything happening in the house of God will touch you.
Na chochote kile ambacho kinafanyika katika nyumba ya Mungu kitakugusa.
Amen.
Amina.
Today leo, on a Sunday,
siku ya Jumapili.
We all know.
Sote tunajua.
That it is a Sunday that we are going also to release our substance.
Kwamba ni Jumapili ambayo pia tutatoa mali zetu.
For the work of God.
Sababu ya kazi ya Mungu.
And what you normally do?
Na kile ambacho sisi ufanye.
Is we tell you are free to remain or to go.
Ni kwamba watu nawaambia mna uhuru wa kubaki ama kuondoka kwenda.
Amen.
Amina.
And last month if my memory doesn't fail me.
Na mwezi jana ikiwa naweza kumbuka.
There was even a meal prepared.
Kulikuwa hata na chakula kimeandaliwa.
And I was told that after the meal people went.
Na nikaambiwa hata baada ya chakula watu waliondoka wakaenda.
Nice lunch, now I can go and swim.
Chakula kizuri cha mchana sasa naweza enda niogelee.
Nice lunch, now I can go and rest on my bed and relax and see and count the things of the room.
Chamcha kizuri sasa naweza enda nitulie kwenye kitanda changu.
About what they are doing in church, that is their own.
Kile kuhusu ambayo wanafanya kanisani, hiyo ni yao.
All I know is that I've eaten.
Yote ambayo najua tu
I've eaten double spiritually and physically.
Nimekula kiroho, nimekula pia.
I went. I praised. I worshiped.
Nikaabudu.
I reported the word.
Nikashiriki.
I was prayed for.
Nikaombewa.
I was given lunch.
Nikapewa chakula.
Five things.
Vitu vitano.
I've benefited.
Nimefaidika.
So this one last one doesn't matter, I go home.
Yeah, mwisho ya ijalishi naenda nyumbani.
I go rest.
Naenda kupumzika.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Jina Bwana tukuzwe.
That also is sad.
Na hiyo pia inahuzunisha.
That also is sad.
Hiyo pia inahuzunisha.
It is because of lack of the zeal.
Ni sababu ya kukosa shauku.
That we have to sing day in day out about home fellowships.
Ambapo kwamba inabidi tuimbe kila siku kuhusu ushirika wa nyumbani.
Amen.
Amina.
It's lack of the zeal.
Ni kule kukosa shauku.
That we have to always remind you one time in a month come for your group fellowships.
Kwamba lazima tuwakumbushe kila mwezi jo sababu ya ushirika.
Fathers come for your fellowship.
Kina baba njoo.
Mothers come for your fellowship.
Kina mama njoo.
You come for your fellowship.
Vijana njooni kwa ajili ya ushirika wenu.
Such things should not even be there.
Vitu kama hivi havipasi kuwepo.
Because the days are set.
Maana zile siku zinajulikana.
When the month is beginning in January.
Wakati mwezi unaanza pale January.
You can look at the calendar and you know that this date in September I'll be having fellowship in church.
Unaweza angalia ile kalenda na uone kwamba hii siku katika mwezi wa 9 nitakuwa na ushirika kanisani.
But because we are in a generation, in a season, in a time that the zeal is dead.
Lakini sababu tuko katika kizazi ama wakati ambapo ile shauku imekufa.
People don't care anymore.
Watu hawajali tena.
Remind them or not remind them, they don't care anymore.
Uwakumbushe usiwakumbushe hawajali tena.
Amen.
Amina.
I'm just talking with you as a family.
Ninaongea tu pamoja nami kama
amen.
Familia.
Amen. I'm talking with you as a family.
Naongea nani?
Somebody is getting something that will change that person's life.
Mtu anapata kitu ambacho kitabadilisha maisha huyo mtu.
And somebody else is saying when shall it be over so that we do the next thing.
Na mwingine anasema itamalizika saa ngapi ili tufanye ambacho
kinafaa. It is because of lack of the zeal.
Ni sababu ya kukosa shauku.
That even when you are told.
Kwamba toka
tunaambiwa
kwamba leo.
We want to have it in a special way.
Tunataka tuwe naye katika njia special.
So Even though you never attend evening services, today come. Lack of the zeal will make you not come, just like you never came last Sunday. Amen. Because it doesn't matter to you. But let us remember this one thing. Christ died for us. And he made us his church, built strongly, against which the gates of hell cannot prevail.
Amen.
Amen. That we may stand in our generation and effectively represent him as our forerunners did. Whom without having to announce they were Christians, they were looked at in their behavior and their walk, and they said they are like Christ. They are Christians. They never said this group is called Christians. It is the people who looked at them and they saw their walk, they saw their behavior, they saw their everything, and they said, yes, they are Christians, they are like Christ.
Wakasema ndio hawa ni wa Kristo, wako kama Kristo.
But can we be spoken of the same in this our generation?
Lakini sisi tunaweza rejelewa vivyo hivyo katika hiki kizazi chetu.
Amen.
Amen.
Can we be spoken of the same in this generation?
Je, tunaweza ongewa hivyo katika hiki
kizazi? As an individual, can you be spoken of the same?
Kama mtu binafsi unaweza nenewa ama ongelewa hivyo?
Amen. Your commitment to him, can it be seen?
Kule kujitolea kwako kwake.
Your zeal for him, can it be seen?
Lile shauku lako kwake, je, linaweza onekana?
Do people see it in your prayer life?
Je, watu wanaiona katika hali yako?
Do they see it in your commitment to witnessing?
Je, wanaiona katika kujitolea kwako?
Do they see it in your giving?
Je, wanaiona katika kutoa kwako?
Do they see it in your attendance of services?
Je, wanaiona katika kuhudhuria kwako kwa ibada?
When they are planning anything outside church,
wakati wanapanga chochote nje ya kanisa,
and they want to include you,
na wanataka kukuhusisha,
do they say,
je, wanasema,
that if you put it on Sunday, just know that you are not going to have so and so,
kwamba ukiweka siku ya Jumapili jua tu hautapata fulani na wa fulani,
or they just boldly come to you and tell you, remember our meeting is on Sunday,
ama wanakupigia tu kwa ujasiri wanakuambia, ah, unajua mkutano wetu ni siku ya Jumapili,
because they know you will come,
sababu wanajua utahudhuria,
and then you come and tell us,
alafu unakuja
unatuambia, last Sunday we were not together,
Jumapili iliyopita tu kwa pamoja,
because I was meeting with our clan,
sababu nilikuwa nikutana na
ukoo, we had a family gathering,
tulikuwa na mkutano wa familia.
What is this?
This
is a family gathering.
He
and this one is an eternal family gathering.
Na huu ni mkutano wa familia wa milele.
Because these are the brethren you will be with eternally if they are truly saved.
Sababu hawa ndio ndugu utakuwa nao milele ikiwa wameokoka cha
kweli. If you are truly saved and they are truly saved,
ikiwa wao wameokoka ile ukweli na wewe.
This is an eternal family.
Hii ni familia milele.
Amen. But you can break away from eternal family.
Lakini unaweza ondoka na kujitoka.
And you are going to that temporal family.
Unaenda kwa ile ya familia ya muda mfupi.
Amen.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ,
Baba wa mbinguni katika jina la Yesu Kristo,
we know that you saved us.
Tunajua kwamba ulituokoa.
You were committed to our salvation.
Ulijitolea kwa ajili ya wokovu wetu.
So much so,
kiasi kwamba,
that nothing said before you would deter you.
Hakuna chochote ambacho kiliwekwa mbele yako ambacho kingekuzuia.
Not the shame.
Si hata aibu.
Not the mockery.
Sio ile dhihaka.
Not the suffering.
Sio kule kuteseka.
Not the pain.
Sio uchungu.
Not even the death.
Si hata kifo.
Even shameful death on the cross.
Hata kifo cha aibu msalabani.
Because you are committed for us.
Sababu umejitolea kwetu.
You didn't have to do it for yourself.
How could she?
You did it for us.
Ulitutendea.
Help us.
Tusaidie.
To understand this.
Kuelewa haya.
That we may also do all.
Ili kwamba tukatende yote.
For you.
Tukutendee wewe.
Not to be stopped by anything.
Tusizuiliwe na chochote kile.
Help us to be bold. Help us to be courageous. Help us to have the zeal. Help us to be jealous for your house. That our lives will be committed unto you. That our time will be committed unto you. That our strength will be committed unto you. That our wealth also will be committed unto you. That we shall be all in all for you. Because you are all in all for us. That you may be glorified in us and in our operations. And that you name may be praised. Thank you, Lord.
Asante Bwana.